Yes, I am. I'm married. When I wrote the book, I was not, though. I started writing it, and I was sort of similar to the character of Kate, who never ever wants to have a wedding. I believed in marriage. Kate does not. But I always sort of thought I would be like her. I wouldn't have a wedding, wouldn't do any of that. I got engaged a year into writing the engagement. So that sort of changed my perspective a bit. And I ended up with this enormous wedding that I was never expecting to have, which gave me a bit of empathy for Kate's cousin, who is so obsessed with his own wedding, and she can't quite understand him. So the two characters were each sort of half of myself, I guess. I think with all of my novels, I come back to the idea that the moment a woman in particular is born, but it's true for men as well, it determines so much of who she or he can become. And I've explored that through young contemporary women in my first novel, a group of women in a family in my second novel. And this time I felt like marriage was sort of the next frontier of relationships that I wanted to write about. And also what it's like to be married now as opposed to 50 years ago. You know, I think especially in the US, our laws have changed so quickly that we sort of forget that it was only 40 years ago that a black man and a white woman could not be married, or that a woman needed her husband's permission to have a credit card. And I wanted to write about how these social and cultural changes have affected everyday couples. I think A Thousand Acres by Jane Smiley would probably be my favorite. Oh, I love how she writes about the women in a family. I love how she writes a story that is so feminine in a way, and yet so hugely important, and a great, great American novel. That is truly a great American novel.